Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to give you a first example of application of the inclusion-exclusion identity, and more precisely we are going to look at the probability that a bridge hand is void in at least one suit. So I just remind you quickly that a bridge hand consists of 13 cards chosen from an ordinary deck of 52 cards. And so the deck we are using is exactly the same as in poker. It's 52 cards that consist of 13 denomination times 4 suits. But contrary to poker, we choose 13 cards instead of 52. So, like the title of the video says, to solve this problem, we need to use the inclusion-exclusion identity. But exactly like for poker probabilities, we assume that our deck of cards is well mixed, which means that in this case, because we choose 13 cards, we have 52 choose 13 possible bridge hands. And all those 52 choose 13 bridge hands are going to be equally likely. So we are indeed in the case of symmetric probability spaces. And so one other important tool to solve this problem is going to be to use those counting rules that we saw in a few videos. So the goal again is going to be about counting cards. So I wrote the event of interest here. We want to find the probability of that event that the bridge hand is void in at least one suit. And here in my hands, I'll show you an example of such an event. Here I have a bridge hand, and you see that this bridge hand is void in hearts. So that's the one possible outcome that is included in this event A. So, to do this, if you look at again these bridge hands, you see that we have exactly three suits. It's void in hearts, and so one natural way to solve the problem, which in fact is a very common mistake, but I'm going to start with a mistake so that you see how it works eventually. It's just to say that to compute the probability of A, first we need to choose one suit that is going to be the suit missing in the bridge hand. In the bridge hand I just showed you, the suit that was missing is hearts. So you start by choosing one of the four suits, and then once you've identified a suit that should not be in the bridge hand, then you choose 13 cards, but making sure that you exclude that suit. So eventually, using this reasoning, you are going to get exactly a 4 choose 1. That's the number of ways you can choose one suit. Then you want to choose 13 cards from the set of 39 cards that are not in that suit that you've chosen. So the 39 comes from 52 minus 13. And so step number 2, you choose from a set of 39 cards, you choose 13. And then that gives you the total number of bridge hands which are void in at least one suit. And then you still need to divide by the total number of bridge hands to get your probability. So eventually you divide this by 52, choose 13. Now, it turns out that even if it's a natural answer, in fact, this is not correct. This is not true. It's in fact much more complicated than that. And just to tell you why it's not true, I prepared another bridge hand here. And so you see that this one is void in two suits. It's void in hearts, like before, but it's also void in spades. And so what's wrong with this suit? Well, you see that when I do the counting here, I can indeed choose hearts here and then choose 13 cards that are not hearts, and then I'm going to count. In doing this counting, I'm going to count this bridge hand. But when I count also that I want to start with a bridge hand which is void in spades, and then I choose spade at step 1, and then I choose 13 cards that are not spades, I count again this poker, this bridge hands. So that means that in fact, these bridge hands that are void in exactly one suit are indeed counting counted once using this formula, but bridge hands like this one that are void in two suits are counted multiple times. This one is counted twice. And so that's the reason why this expression is not correct, in fact. This probability is not equal to this. And so to solve the problem here is really to see the statement here. We say void in at least one suit, so that means void in suits. Let's call them suit 1, 2, 3, 4. And by symmetry, it doesn't matter which one is which one. And so if we call the suits 1, 2, 3, and 4, this event A is exactly the event that the bridge hand is void in suit 1, or void in suit 2, or void in suit 3, or void in suit 4. So that's indeed, A is indeed the union of 4 different events. And we saw that to compute the probability of a union of events, it's very convenient to use the inclusion-exclusion identity. When those events are mutually exclusive, we don't need that, but you see that with my example of the bridge hand void in hearts and spade, you see that those events that bridge hands are void in one given suit are not mutually exclusive, because bridge hands can be void in not just one suit, they can be void in two suits or even three suits. So to take that into account, the fact that those events overlap, their intersection is not empty, we need to use the inclusion-exclusion identity. It turns out that when we use the inclusion-exclusion identity, this term, this probability that's wrong, in fact, that this term is going to be the first term that appears in this double sum. And so we are going to look at that right now. So how can we indeed compute the probability? So we said first we need to write the event A as the union of four events. Those four events are the event AI that the bridge hand is void in suit I. Be careful, void in suit I, let's say heart, for instance, doesn't mean that it's void in only that suit, that can be void in other suits, for instance, spades, like in the example I showed you. And so we want to introduce those events that's well defined for I equals 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then you see that P of A is just equal to P of the union of those AI. So now by the inclusion-exclusion identity, if I extend this big formula that we saw, that says that, so eventually we start with P of A, use the fact that A is the union of the AI, so that's equal to P of A1 union A2 union A3 union A4. And then the inclusion-exclusion identity tells us that the probability of the union here is equal to the probability, the sum of the probabilities, P of A1 plus P of A2 plus P of A3 plus P of A4. That's in fact the number we had before. That's wrong, because that's not enough. We need to subtract with the probability of intersection of any two events, and then add probability of intersection of any three events, and then again subtract probability of intersection of four events. Here we stop at four. That's a lot of terms to write. I'm just going to write kind of the pattern. And so eventually you can prove that this is equal to P of A1 plus P of A2 and so on up to P of A4. Then you need to subtract with intersection of any two events. So eventually you have minus P of A1 intersection A2, then minus P of A1 intersection A3, A1 intersection A4, A2 intersection A3, and so on. And so the last term is going to be P of, let's say, A3 intersection A4, if I use the lexicographic order. Then you have to add the probabilities of intersection of any three events. So you have plus P of A1 intersection A2 intersection A3. You keep going like that. Then the last term is going to be P of A2 intersection A3 intersection F4, then last term in the inclusion-exclusion identity is going to be a minus probability of the intersection of all four. So minus P of A1, intersection A2, and so on, intersection F4. So it looks like a lot of things to compute, but in fact, that's not that difficult. So why it's not difficult in this case? Well, that's because you have perfect symmetry. If you look at all the suits, you can, the problem is you don't change the probability if you exchange the suits. And in fact, you see, we don't even call the suits by their name here. We call that suit 1, 2, 3, 4. So the problem is completely symmetric in all the suits. So what this means is that being void in suit 1 is the same probability of being void in suit 2. And so that means that those four probabilities here are equal. Same story here, being void in, let's say, hearts and spades, or being void in hearts and diamonds, are two events that have the same probability. So that means that all the events here, probability of intersection of any two events, have again the same probability, and so on. So in fact, you can reduce that, and the goal is just to compute four probabilities, but we need to count correctly the number of times those probabilities appear here. So you see that if you look at only one event, this appears four times. So if I look at this block here we have four events. That corresponds to exactly the choice of one out of four events. So I'm going to say that the number of times we add terms here is exactly four choose one. Then, if you look at intersection of any two events, you in fact look at all the possible ways you can choose two of the four events and look at the probability of those intersections. Again, because the probabilities are the same, if you look at this term up to this one, we only have probabilities that are equal. Then we only need to say that this term corresponds to a minus whatever number of terms we have times probability of A1 intersection A2. The number of terms we have here is again the choice of two out of four events. That's a four choose two. So here we have four choose two events of the form P of AI intersection AJ. Then if we look at intersection of three events here, we are going to have exactly four choose three possible ways to choose those events. And then for the last one, there is only one possibility that corresponds to a four choose four, which is indeed equal to one. So eventually, you see that we don't have so many terms. Here we have four, six, four, one. In fact, we only need to look at the probability we only need to look at four probabilities a priori. In fact, it's only three probabilities because if you look at this last event here, that means being void in all four suits. That's not possible. If you just take even just one card, you cannot be void in all four suits. So that means that you can also get rid of this term. This term is in fact equal to zero. So if I recap, eventually, using this reasoning, inclusion-exclusion identity, but combined also with symmetry, the fact that those suits are exchangeable, eventually you end up with something much simpler. And so we get that the probability of A is just equal to P of A. Oops, I'm going to go back to black. P of A is just equal to 4 choose 1 times P of A1. This corresponds to the sum P of A1 plus P of A2 plus P of A3 plus P of A4. That simplifies that way. Then you have a minus 4 choose 2 times P of A1 intersection A2, and then you still need a plus 4 choose 3 times P of A1 intersection A2 intersection A3, and then minus 4 choose 4 but times 0. Okay, so I'm just going to write a minus 0 here, just to remind you that there was something, there is one more term. If you, strictly speaking, use the inclusion-exclusion identity, except that this term is just equal to 0. And so now things are much simpler. Now you can say that this is equal to, so let me take a little bit more space here. So eventually you should have a fraction here, so you have your 4 choose 1 here. And what is this probability? Well, that means that you look at all the possible bridge hands that are void, not in one suit, one of the 4 suits, void in a specific suit, suit number 1. So here, indeed, if you look at the probability of being void in suit number 1, indeed the total number of possible outcomes, the total number of possible bridge hands, is indeed all the possible choices of 13 cards from a set of 39. And in this event, AI, A1 does not exclude that A2 or A3 or A4 can also happen. So eventually P of A1 is indeed equal to what we thought about before. It's going to be this 39 choose 13. Again, this 39 comes from 52 minus 13. That's the total number of cards that are not in suit 1. And then to get indeed the probability, you need to divide by the total number of possible bridge hands, which is clearly 52 choose 13. Then, that's the answer we guessed at the beginning, and that's not correct. And now we see why it's not correct. Indeed, we need this little adjustment here. Of course, the probability of being void in 2 suits or being void in 3 suits is very small, so the quantity here is some kind of not too bad approximation of P of A, but strictly speaking, it's not correct. We still need to have this adjustment to have the exact probability. So then for this probability, we have to subtract by 4 choose 2 times. So this time, the bridge hands should be void in exactly 2 suits. All the cards in those 2 suits, that's a total of 26 cards. So eventually, we have to choose 13 cards from a set of 52 minus 26 cards, which is again 26. So here we have a 26 choose 13 divided by 52 choose 13. Then last adjustment, we need to add here this 4 choose 3 times. Now we want to be void in exactly 3 suits. That means that, I mean, in exactly, I should say, suit 1, 2, and 3. So that's exactly the probability that all 13 cards are in suit 4. That means that we choose all the 13 cards from suit 4. And so that's only one possibility that corresponds to a 13 choose 13. So 13 choose 13 divided by 52 choose 13. So you see the pattern. This is what we thought was true at first, but that's neglecting the overlap that would be true if those events were disjoint, which is not the case. And then you see the full inclusion-exclusion identity here with the plus minus plus that corresponds to probability of only one event minus probability of intersection of any 2 events plus probability of intersection of any 3 events. For 4 events, the probability is 0. So you have this plus, minus, plus, minus. And you see that, again, using symmetry, we can simplify the original inclusion-exclusion identity because all the terms in the last sum of the inclusion-exclusion identity are equal. So that gives you the answer. Going back to the slide, so I rewrote the answer, and if you use a basic calculator to compute those numbers, you obtain that the probability that a bridge hand is void in at least one suit is about 0.0511. So that means about 5% of the time, if you play bridge, you are going to have a bridge hand which is void in at least one suit.